I have a lot of thin white hairs, like peach fuzz, on the hairline. Is it possible for it to thicken with PRP plus ACell?
Thank you for your question. You're asking a question without a photo submitted where you describe having a lot of fine white, like peach fuzz along your hairline, and you're asking specifically if PRP plus ACell will thicken those hairs. Well, I can certainly give you my opinion on this topic. I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and a fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic surgeon, and I'm the founder of TrichoStem Hair Regeneration Centers, which are centers we've developed based on the use of ACell and PRP in a method and system that we've developed over several years, treating hundreds and hundreds of patients from around the world in our offices in Manhattan and Long Island. And I've been in practice for over 20 years. So I understand this type of question because it really requires a truly understanding of what ACell and platelet-rich plasma does for the people that we treat. So to begin with, the peach fuzz that you describe is referred to as vellus hair. Now, this is understanding that this is not fuzz that's there after your hair thinned. Okay, so that we have to distinguish that. Any hair that is in front of thick terminal hairs without hair thinning that you see that's very fine and described as peach fuzz and it tends to be short, that is vellus hair. That hair diameter is like 0.03 millimeters. That's compared to terminal hair, which the diameter is 0.06 millimeters or greater. Now, the point of that statement is that if the vellus hair was not a hair that became that way after the hair thinned, then it's a native vellus hair and was never destined to be a thicker terminal hair. In our experience, when we use ACell PRP or what we refer to as hair regeneration or TrichoStem hair regeneration, the majority of patients we're treating are men and women with pattern hair loss, also known as androgenetic alopecia. This means that the hair starts thick and with each subsequent hair growth cycle becomes thinner. With our treatment of hair regeneration, we're stopping the progression, we are reactivating hairs that are not growing, and then we stimulate thinning hairs to become thicker. So in this scenario, if that quote fuzz that's in the frontal hairline is associated with other hairs that are thinning, then the hair regeneration treatment could thicken those hairs. If those hairs are vellus hairs native to the skin and do not were never thick, then hair regeneration should not make a difference. If you think about what platelet-rich plasma and acellular matrix is intended for, you think about wound healing. And wound healing does not mean that you can just take any hair or any skin or anything like that and just make it thicker. You are actually with pattern hair loss, there is a concept there where there may be a perception of some type of damage or degeneration, which is perceived as an injury and may be the basis on how part of the reason of why hair regeneration works so effectively. When we treat people with hair loss, with hair regeneration, we're essentially correcting a growth cycle that's going in a downward way, where the hair is progressively thinning. But it is still limited by the presence of hair, the degree of hair loss, and so which means that we want to be able to treat people as early as possible. The more hair there is, the better it is. So if you reach a point, for example, where your hair is thin to the point where you are practically bald and you just have a little bit of fuzz, even though you might get that hair to be thicker, it's not going to be that dramatically improved. However, if you have a decent amount of thin hair, that's a different story, and that can be an improvement. So to summarize, if it's a native, normal vellus hair that was never thick, hair regeneration, ACell platelet-rich plasma will not make a difference. If it is hair that is thinning and getting close to disappearing, it can make a difference, but it just depends on the individual one-on-one basis, because we do look at the patient as a whole, and the evaluations have to be clear. When we finish an evaluation, we have to be clear as to the potential benefit of a treatment like hair regeneration. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck. Thank you for your question.